Let's bring in NBC News political analyst Steve Schmidt. Steve, good morning.
Good morning.
Wow, that was a huge upset last night. There was something about this young woman's political ad that did capture a lot of people's attention. Just watch a little bit of it and explain why you think she won.
This race is about people versus money. We've got people, they've got money. It's time we acknowledge that not all Democrats are the same. That a Democrat who takes corporate money, profits off foreclosure, doesn't live here, doesn't send his kids to our schools, doesn't drink our water or breathe our air, cannot possibly represent us.
I mean, powerful ad. What did you see there?
Sure is. You know, politics used to be defined by this vertical line that ran down the middle of the field, and we debate between the 45-yard lines. But just like the message that elected Donald Trump and the message that Bernie Sanders ran on, what she's saying is that there's a group of people above the line. There's one set of rules for them and a different set of rules for everybody else. And those people above the line are screwing all of us below the line. And that message runs and is effective from the left of the Democratic Party all the way across to the Trump voter.
This is what's interesting about why you would have Sanders Trump voters during the last election.
Absolutely.
What does this mean, though? I mean, if all the energy in the Democrat Party is on the far left, and certainly the energy in the Republican Party is with Trump and the far right, how does that play out? If you were going to do a general election, is that good for Trump?
Well, I think it's bad for the country. It could be good for Trump because Trump got elected. And if you looked at the polling, essentially what the American people were telling us, we didn't listen very well, was that there were two unelectable candidates. And that when two unelectable candidates run against each other, one of the unelectable candidates is going to win. And by 78,000 votes in three states, that's what happened to Donald Trump. I think politically, Donald Trump has advantaged the degree to which American politics is radicalized. If the center collapses, I think that benefits Donald Trump.
His numbers, by the way, are going up, as you know. You are a former Republican. You recently kind of stepped away from the party. If you were to answer the question, will Donald Trump be elected again? If you were to ask that question right now, what would your answer be?
Maybe. Look, at the end of the day, politics at the beginning of my political career was a business of persuasion. It has become a business of incitement. And you have on both sides inciters, people trying to increase intensity by raising fervor, by making the other side the absolute enemy. All virtue is found in our party, all evil in the other, all good ideas here, all bad ideas there. And as we have a politics of incitement, what it does is it turns off people in the middle. And so we're at an interesting moment in American politics, but that governing center that created so much prosperity, so much good in the country is getting smaller. It's collapsing.
Steve Schmidt, always interesting to get your perspective. Thank you so much for being here. We appreciate it.
Hello, Today fans. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking that button down there and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives.